Hello, welcome to SS Unitech Social Design, and this is continuation of PySpark performance tuning. So this is part 5 where we are going to understand about the partitioning and bucketing and what is the difference between these two and when we should go with the partition and when we should go with the bucket. So let's get started. So the partitioning in the concept you can understand like this. We are having a data set and we just want to create the partitions based on any column, and it will be picking the different values from that column. That will be the distinct values and will be creating the separate folders in your storage, and under that you will be keeping all those files there, and it will be having only the data for that particular column value. So as you can see in our example, we are having one of the sales data set, and it is having sales order ID, date, customer name, country and amount. So first we are having a query. So the requirement, we should be going to select the data from the sales data set and where the country, that is India. So instead of scanning the whole table, because this table could be very big table as it's a fact table. So if we are going to do the partition on the country column, so it will be picking the distinct values from this country column and will be creating the separate folders accordingly. So the first thing, we can go and we can create the partition on this country. So as we can see, we have India, then we have Sri Lanka, and then again we have China. So it will be creating total 3 folders that you can see. First folder will be keeping the data for India, then it is going to keeping the data for Sri Lanka, and third it will be keeping the data for China. So here, instead of scanning the whole table, that is total 9 records as of now we are having, so instead of scanning all the 9 records, if we are doing the partition, then it will be scanning only 3 records. So you can assume like the scan has been reduced by 66%. So earlier it was 100%, so you can simply assume like it is scanning only 33%. So 1/3 part it is scanning from whole table. So it's good if you are having big table and the query like this. But let's assume if we are having the query which is select asterisk from your sales table where the country is India, and additionally we are adding one more condition, that is S date is something. So this query might not be helpful here, because first it will go and try to scan inside the India, and if further we are going to do the partition on this S date, then what will be happening? It will be going to create another partitions that you can see here on S date, and it will be having another subfolders under that. So here, as we have 3 records with 3 different S date values, so it will be creating total 3 folders under the India, and that will be having like 25/09/24, similarly 26/27/09/24, and it is having only a single record. So while it will start the scanning, so first it will go on India, so it will lie here, and then we have total 3 folders. So it will check about this folder and it will directly jump on that folder and will pick the data from that folder. So as we don't have as much big data, so on those scenarios for keeping all these separate multiple folders is not a good practice, because it will be keeping all those smaller files, and as we are creating these many number of small files, so we have to maintain all those files. So sometimes it's very difficult to maintain all those large number of files. So what we can do on this scenario, because this data set that you can see is very small, only 9 records is here, and it is total creating 3 folders here, and after that 3 folders in each. So total we can simply multiply and it will be creating total 9 partitions. So for 9 records it will be creating 9 partitions, so that is not a good practice. So what we can do next on this? So instead of going for creating the partitions on both the columns, we can go with the bucket. So what bucket will be doing? So inside the bucket, we have to specify on which column we want to create the bucket, and second, how many records we want to keep in each bucket. So that we have to specify here. So here, as we could see, we are going to create total 3 buckets here, and it will be going to distribute the number of records accordingly. It will create the bucket. This is not the partition actually, this should be the bucket. So it will be creating 3 different buckets based on the country. So here, as I have distributed this into 3 different chunks, first will be India, second will be Sri Lanka, and third will be China. We can also increase the bucket, so we can specify 4, 5 or 6 according to our need. We can simply create that. So it will be going to create those mini number of files, and it will be keeping the data accordingly. So as we can see here, we have only 3 folders for 9 records, but in the first option we are having total 9 folders in total 9 records. So this we can see maintaining is very easy in case of the bucketing. So we can simply understand, if your table is very big, on those scenarios we should go with the partitioning. If your table is not as much big, then we can go with the bucketing. So let's jump into the practical and we'll see there. So here I am going to execute the first query, so it will be creating the data frame. So let me start the cluster first. So here first I am going to create the same data set that we have seen in the slide. So let me try to execute this. So it will be going to have total 5 columns with 9 records, so that we can see here. So here I am going to execute this query for writing this data frame inside your file, and the format of the file will be Parquet, and here we are going to save in this location, that is the output location of the partitions data new. So let me try to execute. So once this query will be executed, your data frame will be saved in the Parquet file, and this Parquet file will be having total 3 subfolders under this folder, and your 3 subfolders will be India, Sri Lanka and China, and under that we'll be going to have the actual data. As it got executed successfully, so let me go here and let me try to refresh this. So under the output we should be having this. So let me open this, and under this we can see it is having total 3 subfolders. That first is the China, second is the India, and third is the Sri Lanka. So these 3 subfolders we are getting, we have partitioned our data on the basis of country. So if we can open under this, then we should be able to see the actual data. So the total 2 files we are having, like these are the partitions files we are having. So these 2 files will be containing the data for India, and if we can go for China, then we will be going to see like only this one file will be going to have the data for China. So similarly we can also check for Sri Lanka. So Sri Lanka will be going to have like these 2 partitions. Now the first part is done. The second part, if we are going to create the partition based on our second query, that is on date. So let me try to go here and let me try to execute this query. So this time I am going to do the partition on country and your date. So these 2 columns will be going to partition. So under the country again we'll be going to see total 3 folders. So those 3 subfolders will be containing the data for that particular day. So it got executed successfully. So let me go back here and let me try to refresh this first, and then here we are having the same data that we can see. Let me go inside the China, and under the China we can see we are having total 3 subfolders again, and under those subfolders we'll be going to see those files. So this will be containing the information for that particular day. So this file will be having that data. So now you can think, from here we are having total 3 folders here, and under that we are having 3 subfolders as well. So total 3 multiplied by 3, so total 9 folders has been created, and based on that it will be going to have the data. So while we are going to maintain these 9 files and folders based on total 9 records, it's very difficult. So on those scenarios we can go with the bucket, and bucket will be going to have only 3 folders, and those 3 folders will be keeping the information for your whole data frame. I hope guys you have understood when we can go with bucket, when we can go with the partition. So interviewer generally ask this question, what is the difference between these two, when we can go with the partition, when we can go with the bucket. So thank you so much for watching this video. See you in the next video.